Hello guys, welcome back. So for today, we will continue our discussion, our chapter 2, which is all about the computer. So we have done discussing its display devices, input text devices. Now let's proceed with one of its output devices, which is through printing and scanning. So we all know what is printing. So halos tanan kita nagpa-print from photocopies, images, tanan kapaprinta. So image that we printed usually are formed through small dots. So we also printed graphics through pictures, colored pictures. So there are critical features when printing. So first one is the resolution. So we all know that resolution is very part when resolution is one to be considered, especially when it comes to printing, because the higher the resolution, mas mubugat ang imong object nga inog print, but with good quality. So it's up to you on how you will set your preferred resolution. So ikaw na nakabalana, because you are the one that knows the capability of your computer. So resolution really matters. So it's usually measured in dots per inch or DPI. So in terms of its speed, so it can be measured in pages per minute. So magdepending kung pilang iyahang ma-print kada minute. So there are different types of dot-based printers. So first one is the dot matrix printer. So kaning dot matrix printer, it uses ink ribbon. So pareha ni siya typewriter na siya ribbon, and then mo siya mo print. So typical resolution ani is 80 to 120 DPI ang iyang gina-print ani. Another type of dot-based printer is kaning inkjet. So nakadungog na mo aning inkjet and bubble jet printers. So this uses tiny blobs of ink that is sent from printhead to paper. So it usually prints 300 DPI. So the third one is kaning laser printer. So pinaka-common bagong ang gawas karon is kaning laser printer. So like photocopier, dots of electrostatic charge deposited on drum which pick up toner rolled into paper which then fixed then heat. So usually this has a resolution of 600 DPI kaning gigamit sa laser printer. Let's proceed with fonts. So computers uses different fonts. So line-line, when you say fonts, line-line o kung saan ang mga kuan, design sa text yung gigamit. So font is very important when developing or making a system, especially in its user interface and yung UI, because it should be readable, mas maayo kung mas nindot na font ang yung gigamit. So font, ang example ani niya kaning Courier, Helvetica, Times New Roman, and others, daghan kini sila. So when it comes to its size, they are usually measured in inches. So from or point, mausob-usob lang mo, inches or point. So upon developing a system, please consider the size of the font that you will be using, or even the style, font style that you will be using. So font has also has its own characteristics. One is the pitch or iyang kabag, iyang kalap dun. So there are two types of pitch in a font. First one is the fixed, wherein every character has the same width. For example, kan sa Courier, or if you try to see, pareha ra gyud siya kadak-on nga tanan nga part sa iyang font. And other also example, another type of pitch is kaning variable pitch, wherein dili sila pareho, some characters are wider. So nasa yung mga ingon ani, but it's up to you when you will be applying this one in creating your user interface systems. It's up to you on how you can attract your user. Another characteristics of a font is whether it is a serif or sans serif. So sans serif, they have square and then strokes. Wala na siya kuan, kumpara wala na siya mga talinis-talinis nga pakapin. Example kaning Helvetica. So tanaw nimo wala siya mga kuan tumoy. While the serif, it has splayed ends. So na siya yung mga tumoy-tumoy. Example is kaning sa Times New Roman and the Palatino. So it's very important to consider what style of the font that you will be using, whether it be serif or sans serif. When it comes to the readability of your text, be sure to try to focus on this one also, whether you will be using lowercase, when to use lowercase, and when to use uppercase. So if you will be using lowercase, it's easy to read shape of words. And when say uppercase, better for individual letters and non-words. So if nakay mga code, usual anang style ginagamit is uppercase na siya tanan, because it's more readable, mas kuan siya, mas makakas po siya attention. So serif fonts also. So as what I have said, you should be consider on what characteristics of font will be using. So we'll see. If you try to use the serif fonts, it helps your eye on long planes of printed text. But sans serif open better on screen. So pang print, pwede nimo gamiton ang serif. While if pang project nimo, pwede mo gamiton ang sans serif. Let's continue with computer memory. So it's not just human that has memory. Computer also has its own memory, and I know for sure you are aware of that. So it has a short-term memory, which is considered it's sometimes called as its RAM. So RAM, random access memory, mo siya kalabanan gina pangita nato ang palitag device. So it is a silicon chips, usually volatile, and data transfer at around 100 megabytes per second. But as of today, mga dagko na kaya mga RAM ro, no? Mas greater na ang ilahang data nga ma-process. So ang RAM is capable of, as what I have said, it is capable of storing your information while your computer is up or gaon. Yung inyong computer, so si RAM ang handle sa tanan ng mga application o mga files na ipang open. So, trabaho na ni RAM while nag-on ang computer. But it is not permanent, because during it turn off ang computer or palungon ang computer, mawala po na siya ng mga stored memory sa RAM. So wala na niya, ibalhin niya dito sa lain nga memory. So another one is the long-term memory or kaning disk, or others call this as ROM, the read-only memory. So gikan ka RAM, napoy ROM. So ang ROM ay capable of storing files for a long period of time. So trabaho na ni RAM ang mag save og files. So kung si RAM, while ga up ang computer, is stored sa karam, sa karom naman is while nakapalog ang computer, automatic na mobalhin dito sa karom. So it's usually in a form of a disk. So kanatong mga hard disk. So nay magnetic disk. So ang magnetic disk, these are proper disks which are stored around 1.4 megabytes. So hard disk typically 400 gigabytes, but na yung mga hard disk ron, even SSD na gani ang taro, no? So nag-evolve, SSD na ang karon, wala na igagamit kayo ang hard disk. So SSD or the solid state drive, it is much faster than the hard disk. We also have the optical disk. It uses laser to read and sometimes write. So katong mga sa CD na to, gagamit mo nila yung mga optical disk. So ang gamit pagbasa na nila is they're using the laser for it to be read. Now let's talk of compression. So in computers, before data are being saved, so there are ways to shrink para pa gamayon pag anon kana siya nga file. So there is a way to do that, and that is through compression. So in compression, the file size will be reduced so that the storage required will be acquired. So mas kung kinahanglan ka gamay nga storage, bugat imong file, pwede na siya nimong i-compress. So there are two different styles of compression. First is the lossless. So in the lossless compression, it allows the original data to be perfectly reconstructed for the compressed data, from the compressed data. I mean to say, walay mawala niya, i-compress ng imuhang data, but walay mga wala sa imuhang data. I mean to say, intact, ra gyapon. While in lossy compression, it is a method of data compression in which the size of the file is reduced by eliminating data in the file. So meaning to say, nasa pa ng tangon dito. Say for example, if ang imuhang image, ang imuhang i-compress is an image. So it could be nga ang effect is that na imo guspaw sa iyang mga colors kay ihang pa ng tangon ang uban niya nga na yung mga element nga iyang tangtangon sa sulod. So that could be it. Now let's talk of the storage formats. So in computers, there are different storage formats in saving or storing a file. So if it is a text, muni sila ang mga format sa text: the ASCII, the UTF-8, the RTF, SGML, and the XML and others. Daghan pa ni sila kayo, the text. So mura ni sila common kayo nga katong unang mga ng gawas. And in media also, daghan po tag storage format sa media. In if it is an image, nata yung mga GPG, JPEG, daghan na, TIFF. And if we will also saving audio, video, daghan po na yung mga MP4, MP3, WAV, daghan kayo ni sila. So these are the storage formats of data in a computer.